Have you ever questioned how touch works? Biologically speaking, what happens when something touches our skin? To start understanding touch, we need to travel back to the 1800s, when anatomists found different cell complexes that could detect touch.
Wait, why would we need more than one type of cell to feel touch?
Good question. Take for example this mechanical pencil. When holding it, you can feel its curvature, the roughness of the eraser, and the pencil lead pressing against your finger. Each type of cell complex is specialized in sensing a particular aspect of touch. Some detect vibrations and changes in pressure, while others detect the edge of an object, a light touch, or the skin stretching. These findings laid the foundations for understanding how touch is not only one type of sensor that detects everything, but many types of sensors, which combined, we feel as touch. Now, the feeling of touch is not generated in our hands, but in our brain, which means the signals generated from something or someone touching our skin have to travel up to the brain. To learn about this, we need to move forward in time. In the 1920s, Joseph Erlanger and Herbert Gasser were studying the differences between nerve fibers. And during their experiments, they noticed some nerves would only transmit an electrical signal when there was a soft touch on the skin, while others would send a signal when there was some harmful stimuli, like a needle poking the skin. Basically, they identified that different nerve types would transmit different information to the brain. And fun fact, they won a Nobel Prize in medicine for these findings.
Dr. Joseph Erlanger, who shares the 1944 prize for physiology and medicine with Dr. Herbert Gasser.
By 1941, Gasser had already classified the nerve fibers into type A, B, and C, with the type A fibers also having subtypes, A alpha, A beta, and A delta. A alpha fibers represent the thickest and fastest conducting nerves. As we move in alphabetical order, fibers become thinner and slower, with the C fibers representing the thinnest and slowest conducting fibers. Nowadays, and because of their work, we know fibers A, beta, and C with a low threshold, which means they are activated with light stimulation, are very important for sensing touch. While we knew A, beta, and C fibers were important for touch in frogs and mammals, finding the difference between A, beta, and C fibers in humans took quite a while. It was only until the 1970s when scientists finally had the opportunity to study rare cases of patients lacking either the A-beta or the C-fibers. Two patients, only known by their initials GL and IW, did not have A-beta fibers, and they couldn't feel the pressure of their fingers holding a pencil, the softness of a sofa, or the curvature of an egg. At the time, scientists thought this made sense because it was consistent with the view that in humans, A-beta fibers were essential to feel touch. But this changed when GL was gently stroked with a soft brush on the forearm of the skin, a region where we have a lot of C-fibers, and she felt something, something nice. This was the first hint that C-fibers were detecting affection through light touch. Interestingly, patients lacking C-fibers, so the other way around from GL, they could still feel and recognize an object they were touching with their hands, but when gently stroked on the forearm, they didn't feel it as pleasant. So why do these fibers have such a different role? One type of fiber seems to be more involved in analyzing the object, and the other is more involved in how touch makes us feel. The answer lies in the brain regions these fibers are connected to. The A-beta fibers activate the somatosensory cortex, which is the part of the brain analyzing the physical sensations of touch. In contrast, C-fibers light up the insular cortex, and this part of the brain is involved with emotion processing. If we connect all these findings together, we know which cell complexes or sensors can detect certain types of stimulation. We can follow the fibers going all the way to different brain regions and start to understand how the information is processed in a more analytical and emotional way. But up to the 21st century, we still didn't understand how touch is converted into an electrical signal. Our senses have a mechanism to convert a stimulation from the outside world into an electrical signal. This signal travels up to our brain, which processes the information and allows us to see, hear, smell, taste, and basically feel our bodies interacting with the outside world. But until 2009, we didn't know how our body converted touch into an electrical signal. This mechanism was finally discovered in 2010 by Dr. Arjun Pataputian, and he was awarded the 2021 Nobel Prize in Physiology for these findings. Pataputian first found a type of neuron that would activate after poking it with a micropipette. He then began to switch off genes potentially involved in initiating the electrical signal. His team would switch one gene off, poke the neuron, and check if there was an electrical current. They did this with 72 genes, one by one, and eventually discovered two proteins converting the mechanical signal into an electrical one. These proteins are two ion channels, now named Piezo1 and Piezo2. Piezo comes from the Greek word for pressure. These two channels open when the cell is under physical pressure, allowing positive ions to enter the cell and generate an electrical current. And this is where we are at right now. Scientists are still studying how touch, the lack of touch, or a disorder associated with touch affects us, and how this information can be used to develop drugs or treatments for a variety of conditions. For instance, Pataputian believes his findings of the piezo ion channels will help scientists develop drugs to alleviate disorders like chronic pain by targeting these proteins. Before the summary and wrapping of this video, make sure to subscribe and touch the like button if you want to see more videos like this. I will also leave a link at the end of this video about a disorder that makes people hate sounds made by other fellow humans. Click on it if you're interested. In summary, gentle touch is detected mainly by the A-beta and C fibers with low threshold activation. A-beta fibers primarily transmit signals for analyzing the object, while C fibers are involved in detecting soft and pleasant touch. The piezo ion channels are the key proteins involved in converting the external touch into an electrical signal, and that if you study how touch works, you're more likely to be awarded a Nobel Prize. See you in the next video.